of your attention, and I will direct it as the program begins to my right, your left. Good evening and welcome to the 2023 9/11 Memorial Ceremony. And welcome to all of you who have come this evening to remember the events of the 11th day of September 2001. And a special welcome to our honored guests who are here to join us this evening for our memorial ceremony. For all Americans and for all time, the phrase 9/11 will remind us of a moment in our history when the world as we knew it changed forever. At 8:45 a.m. on that September 11th morning, I tuned my classroom TV with my second period class and watched as more than 3,000 men and women and children lost their lives in New York, Washington, D.C., and a field in Pennsylvania. So it is fitting that we, in the Webster community, join with Americans everywhere to honor those who perished that day and those who subsequently have been affected by their response to those tragic events. If you are standing, I would ask you to join me in a moment of silent prayer and reflection as a tribute to those lives that were cut short and in memory of the empty places left behind in the hearts of those still living. Thank you. And now I would like you to remain standing as Deputy Town Supervisor Patricia Cataldi leads us in the Pledge of Allegiance, and that will be followed by the Webster Village Band playing the Star Spangled Banner.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Detail, attention! Present, arm!
Up Father Joseph DeMaio to give us our opening prayer.
God of compassion and strength, we ask you to bless with your peace those victims and courageous responders who have gone before us. this time of confusion and hostility, bless those responders who, like them, are now working selflessly, tirelessly, courageously for justice and peace. Bless those who lead us. Give them clear vision to see what is truly good and the courage to see it through. For without truth, there is no justice. And without justice, there is no peace. Bless those among us who are living quiet, honest, unassuming lives. They make this world a better place. Bless our nation, our state, our county, our town, our village. Keep us strong, faithful to what is truly good, and ever mindful that good is stronger than evil, and that we conquer evil with good. Amen.
Now the chorus of the Genesee will lead us in the battle hymn of the Republic. May be seated. Thank you, gentlemen. And now, I'd like to introduce to you our Monroe County Legislator, Mark Johns, who has a few words for us.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Mark Johns. I'm a lifelong Webster resident, and I have the honor and privilege these days of representing you down in the Monroe County Legislature. Thank you for that honor. Also want to thank the Mayor, Dale Byards, for the fact that Webster, the Village Board as well, the Webster Village puts this on every year. This is year 22. It's great to see everybody coming out to honor our first responders especially. I want to give a shout out to the police, the firefighters, the first responders. On that day back in 2011, as everybody was running to safety out of those buildings, we had first responders running the other way. And hundreds of them perished trying to save their fellow Americans' lives. This is the greatest country in the world. I believe that, and I know that you all believe that. We have 6, 7, 8 million people coming into this country, legally and illegally, every year. That's how great this country is. And we should have an orderly, legal way of having people come in, check their backgrounds. But the fact is, this country has more immigrants coming in than any other country. That's a sign of how great we are. People want to be here. You don't see anybody trying to sneak into China or Russia, do you? This is America. I'm glad to be a part of it. I'm glad to represent my district out here. I'm glad for all of you to be able to come down here and join us every year for this special event. Thank you all so much. God bless all our first responders. And God bless all of us Americans. Thank you. Appreciate it.
Now I'd like to ask to come up Monroe County Legislator George Hebert.
Good evening, everyone, and thank you for joining us this evening. I'm George Hebert, and I'm a retired U.S. Navy commander. And for the rest of this year, my eighth and final, I am the county legislator for District 15, which represents most of Webster west of Five Mile Line Road and some of Webster north of Clem Road. So why are we gathered here this evening? We didn't come tonight because it's a beautiful evening, although we're blessed that it is. We didn't come to get out of the house, although we all are. We didn't come to get ice cream afterwards either, when this is over, although we may. So why are we here? We came tonight because 22 years ago today, our nation experienced the worst attack on American soil that has ever occurred. Nearly 3,000 of our fellow countrywomen, countrymen, and children died in a cowardly, senseless terrorist act, turning civilian aircraft into what were essentially cruise missiles. I'm going to ask for a little audience participation for just a second and a show of hands. Are any in the crowd, were any of you born on or after September 11th, 2001? There are at least a few hands that should go up in the back. And there are. How many of you were born after September 11th, 1997? Any more? One, maybe. Well, in all likelihood, those who raise their hands only have memories based on things that they've been told by their parents or others, or videos you've seen regarding that terrible day. Some may have no memories at all. As we move forward in time, the numbers of people whose memories have faded will grow. I can safely say for those of us age 27 and older, we vividly remember the events that happened that day. We know exactly where we were when we first heard the news. I was in my car leaving a meeting in Kodak Park when a friend called to inform me. We know precisely what our first actions were after we heard that news. Instead of returning to work, I drove to a Catholic school where I was chairman of the school advisory committee to help manage the situation there. We remember the television scenes, those desperate people leaping from the towers, as fires roared on the floors below them, blocking any other possible exit. We remember being glued to the TV, watching police and firemen, as Mark John said, rush into the Twin Towers to rescue people still inside, and then watching in horror as the Twin Towers fell one after the other, with those people and people who work there on a day-to-day basis still inside. That day is forever sealed into our memories. The pain, the terror, the tremendous loss, the fear for our loved ones, and also for the incredible displays of courage. Because of television, we remember that day better than our parents and grandparents remember Pearl Harbor. My daughters, who were 7 and 8 years old that day, have vivid memories of watching television news coverage of the two commercial jetliners crashing into the towers and another striking the Pentagon. We only got to hear about the one that was crashed outside of Shanksville, Pennsylvania, where the passengers, showing that ever-standing American spirit, revolted against their captors and refused to let another U.S. landmark, likely the U.S. Capitol or White House, be obliterated. What else do we remember? Well, I remember a lot of little things that followed. If you went down any of these streets in Webster, you saw U.S. flags flying from nearly every home, every business, every street. I remember the volunteers who flocked to New York City to help in any way they could. I remember the solidarity of our countrymen to hold accountable those responsible for these acts. I also remember when the baseball season reopened with a game at Yankee Field. Where else but in New York City? There's so much more we all remember. But why do we remember this day tonight? Why is it important to remember this day? Well, there are days we must never forget. The terrorist attacks of September 11, 2001 brought loss and grief on a scale we had never known. In the dark days that followed, the indomitable spirit of our village, our town, our state, and our nation shined more brightly than ever as stories of heroism and sacrifice inspired us all. On that terrible day, a nation became a neighborhood. All Americans became New Yorkers. If we learn nothing else from this tragedy, we learn life is short and there is no time for hate. These acts shattered steel, but they did not dent the steel of the American people's resolve. Eventually, we brought justice to the perpetrators. But even before that, our nation met tragedy with humanity. While we can't reverse the occurrences at the World Trade Center, the Pentagon, or in Shanksville, Pennsylvania, we can choose to focus on the goodness that came out of such tragedy. Family, friends, co-workers, neighbors, and yes, believe it or not, even politicians, all came together to check on loved ones, support them in grief, and lend a helping hand to those in need. That is the country we strive to be. On the anniversary of September 11th and always. We're here tonight to join this day recommitting to make America a better place today than it was yesterday, as Americans have always done. I think that, friends, that's why we're here. Therefore, I urge you to be sure to check on your loved ones and be sure to support them, whether they are experiencing joyous times or times of grief. Lend a helping hand to others who are in need. Go a little further and volunteer at a local organization. Pass up that second latte of the day and donate to some organization that needs your help. Let's show the world our community is as special as I know it to be. That is the way we can honor those who lost their lives on that tragic day and remember their sacrifice. May God bless you and your loved ones, our village and town, and our nation. Go Bills tonight. Beat those darn Jets. Thank you.
And now, I would like to have the Webster Village Band again play God Bless America. Thank you. And now I would like to invite up to have a few words the Monroe County Fire Coordinator, Steve Shalaba.
Let's hear it for the band, huh? Good evening, and thank you for asking the Fire Bureau to join you on this very important remembrance. The events of September 11th were simply horrific. And today, 22 years later, we remember the 343 New York firefighters, the 71 police officers, and the 8 EMTs that made the ultimate sacrifice and died in the line of duty. We also know that many more have succumbed to their injuries since that time while working at the site of the former World Trade Center. In fact, a heartbreaking milestone haunts the 9/11 anniversary today. 341 FDNY members have now died of Ground Zero related illnesses, nearly equaling the death toll of firefighters who perished in the 2001 attack. There, of course, were also civilians with similar stories, like Darcy Borders, who became known as the Dust Lady. Her iconic photo of being covered in debris was seen around the world. Everything in that photograph was astonishing, as she literally appeared to be frozen in time. As Darcy battled from depression, rehab, and all of the trauma of that day, cancer also dealt her a fatal blow on August 24th, 2015, at the age of 42. Her story is beyond moving, as it further showcases how our routine, everyday lives were turned upside down in an instant on that crisp blue sky Tuesday morning. You know, September 11th was a very personal day for all of us. For me, I was obsessed with hearing from those that were actually there. Each of their stories unique, and each one giving us a different glimpse into how their ordinary day was transformed into anything but. My collection of books quickly grew as various members of the fire service, people in leadership positions, and others brought us into their world that day. The stories were simply amazing. The emotions were raw, but they showcased that the American spirit could not be broken. So, despite our grief, we also had a great sense of pride within the fire service. People looked at us differently. They started to figure it out. They understood the commitment, the courage, and the selfless acts of bravery that firefighters showcase across this nation every day. I'm sure some of you watched the 60 Minutes special last evening. The one moment in the segment that caught my attention most was when the interviewer asked Chief Pfeiffer, who was the first battalion chief on scene and who initially assumed command of the incident, how many firefighters refused to go up the stairs of the World Trade Center knowing that the situation was not looking good. And he simply said, and just stared at the interviewer in a way that I thought was interesting, he said nobody refused to go in, including his own brother, Kevin Pfeiffer, who was an FDNY lieutenant on Engine 33 and subsequently passed away in the collapse a short time after receiving his orders. Chief Pfeiffer responded to this question without arrogance or circumstance. He and the entire New York City Fire Department were focused on rescuing as many people as possible from the upper floors of the Twin Towers, and that is what they did. Unfortunately, time was not on their side. Their service and their actions, though, were extraordinary. In closing, I suspect that this sense of pride, along with a strong desire to have a place to gather, to reflect, and to show respect for those that were lost, is what brought us together today. I would like to thank the Webster community for their work with this program and for their commitment to never forget. The Fire Bureau would also like to recognize the local responder community here in Webster, who always stands ready to help your neighbors on a moment's notice. We are proud of your service and grateful for all that you do. Thank you.
Thank you, Steve. And now I would like to ask the chorus of the Genesee First to sing When There's Love at Home, and that will be followed by the Webster Village Band playing America the Beautiful.
Yeah.
thank you to both the Chorus of the Genesee and also the Webster Village Band. On September 11th, pictures will stay with us more than words. The fires, falling debris, bodies, the haunting faces that we saw on the news. On one of the worst days in American history, we saw some of the bravest acts also in American history. As buildings fell, heroes rose. There were employees who ran into smoke-filled corridors to lead others to safety. Firefighters whose selfless sense of duty and compassion led them to search for victims. For those security guards who directed panicked workers away from Ground Zero, and for emergency personnel who tended to the wounded and the injured, and the passengers on Flight 93 who chose self-sacrifice to save countless others. We should not, and we will not, ever forget the victims and the heroes of 9/11/2001. We will remember and honor every person, every rescuer who responded that day, and those that gave their lives and have continued to give their lives for others.